Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have completed our first chapter, right? So we have completed the introduction to computers chapter, and today we are moving on to the second chapter. Okay, in the second chapter, if you see, it is a number system chapter. Okay, here you will have some how to do some calculations, and here binary, just simple calculations only. Here you will be converting a normal decimal number to a binary number, or a binary number to a decimal number. And this chapter will be easy if I teach you directly, so that if you have any doubts you can ask me directly. So I'll just skip this chapter for now and we'll move on to third chapter. Okay, after completing the other chapters which is related to computer, we'll just come back to the second chapter. Okay, if school is not reopening, I'll take this second chapter online itself. As if now, we'll just skip the second chapter. First chapter, we have seen the introduction to computer, and today we'll be learning about computer organization. That is the things inside computer, the hardware parts inside computer and how it works, about that and all we'll see. So that as soon as learning the introduction of computer, if you are learning about the parts inside, the hardware components of computer, means it will be easy, right? So in this computer organization chapter, that is your third chapter, okay? So here you'll be learning the organization of computer components and the interconnections inside this computer, okay? So here the objective is to know about the processor and their characteristics, okay? Here you'll know the importance of a memory device and the role in a computer. Okay, the role of this memory devices in a computer, and you'll explore about RAM, ROM, and you'll differentiate what RAM means, what is a ROM, about this and all you'll be learning here, and also about cache memory, how it improves the performance of a computer, and you'll know about the secondary devices and their usage, and also to know about the ports and interfaces so that the external devices can be connected to a computer. Okay, first let's see the introduction about computer organization. Computer organization means this deals with the hardware components of the computer. Hardware means, first itself I have explained to you, hardware means the physical components or the parts or devices which are present along with the computer is hardware. Okay, so software means it's a set of instructions or a set of programs which is given to operate or to do a specific task. It is a instruction, or it may be a coding, that is a software. And hardware means it is a physical component. Okay, so here this computer organization deals with all the hardware parts of a computer system. This will include the input device, output device, central processing unit, storage device, memory units and all. Okay, it is concerned with how the various components of a computer hardware will operate. This also deals with how these things are interconnected, how this architecture of the computer is designed, how the specifications are there. So about this and all we'll be learning in this chapter. Okay, so this computer organization, this word, if you see, this will look like a computer architecture, but computer architecture means it will be defined as a engineering considerations involved in designing a computer. Architecture means it will just involve the engineering considerations which can be involved in designing a computer. Okay, on the other hand, if you see, computer organization means, you know, it deals with the hardware components that are transparent to the programmer. That means the hardware components which you can see, which the user can see, is known as computer organization. Okay, so here mainly you will be learning about microprocessor, and the characteristics of microprocessor is a very important question in this chapter. Okay, first let's see the basics of microprocessor. In the CPU, if you see here, that CPU is the major component in a computer to perform any kind of task. This is realized by microprocessor. That means it is a integrated circuit. You will have heard that IC, and IC means integrated circuits. Okay, this microprocessor was first introduced in the year 1960. 70. Okay, this is the first general purpose microprocessor 4004. This was developed by Intel Inc. Okay, the microprocessor was first introduced in the year 1970s. Okay, this microprocessor means it is a programmable multi-purpose silicon chip. This microprocessor will be designed with the help of a silicon. It is a multi-process purpose. That means it can be used for so many purpose. So it is given as multi-purpose and it can be programmable. You can program a chip, right? So this microprocessor is a programmable multi-purpose silicon chip. This is driven by a clock pulse. It like a clock seconds needle is there, right? Likewise, here also clock pulse will be there. According to that clock pulse only, this microprocessor will work. Okay, here it will accept the input in binary data. Binary means it's nothing but number. Okay, like in max we are using 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, right? Likewise, in binary we'll have numbers, but only two numbers will be there, only 0 and 1. Okay, binary means 0 and 1. Binary 0 and 1 only will be there. If the value is true, it will be denoted as 1. If the value is false, it will be denoted as false. Okay, 0. 0 is false and 1 is true. Okay, so here this accepts the input as a binary data, and after processing, it provides the output data as per the instruction. The set of program or set of instructions will be given, right? So as per this instruction, the data will be processed and the output data will be stored in the memory. Okay, so here they have given this process of a microprocessor in a block format. Here if you see, input will be given into a microprocessor and it will process and it will keep the data in the memory, and also it will give the output. Okay, so inside microprocessor it will have three main units. Microprocessor means it is made up of three main components, that is ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, control unit and memory unit. Okay, so here memory unit will say it as registers. Okay, here ALU is arithmetic and logic unit. To perform this arithmetic and logic instructions, we'll have this arithmetic and logic unit. Okay, as per the instructions, the arithmetic and logic operations will be done. Okay, so arithmetic and logic instructions are given means those instructions will be executed inside this ALU, arithmetic and logic unit. Okay, and control unit. Control unit means this controls the overall operation of the computer through signals. Okay, and another unit is memory unit. Memory unit means registers. Registers are the internal memory which holds the instructions and the data for the execution of the processor. You'll be giving a data and you'll be giving an instruction to perform a task, right? So both this instruction and data will be saved inside this memory unit, or saved inside this internal memory, which is called as register, and this is used for the execution of this processor. Okay, so you know what is microprocessor, and let's see the characteristics of microprocessor. Okay, microprocessor means this performs as with some characteristics. So let's see the characteristics now. First one is clock speed, and the next one is instruction set, and the next one is word size. Okay, so here three characteristics of microprocessor is given: clock speed, instruction set and word size. Okay, clock speed. First let's see the definition of clock speed. Okay, clock speed means every microprocessor will have an internal clock. This will be measuring, or this will be regulating the speed of the instruction execution. The execution of the instruction will be depending upon this internal clock only. As per the clock speed only, this microprocessor will work. Okay, so the speed of this microprocessor executes an instruction is called the clock speed. This is measured in megahertz, MHZ or gigahertz, that is GHz is it, okay? So every microprocessor will have an internal clock. This will give the execution speed, or the speed of the executed instruction will be based on this microprocessor only. So the speed at which the microprocessor executes the instruction is known as clock speed. This is the main characteristics of a microprocessor. Okay, the clock speed can be measured in megahertz or gigahertz. Okay, and the next characteristics is instruction set. A command which is given to a computer to perform any operation on a data is known as instruction. A set of instruction or set of coding or set of program will be given to perform a specific task, right? So this command is known as instruction set. Okay, so the basic set of machine language will be have designed to execute the instruction set in this microprocessor. Okay, the basic set of machine level instruction that a microprocessor is designed to execute is known as instruction set. Instruction is nothing but a command, or it may be a code. You can just say add this to, like that. If you are giving an instruction to a computer, that is a instruction that will come under this instruction set only. Okay, so the basic set of machine level instruction, machine level instruction in the sense, in the language which the machine understands, that is machine level instructions that a microprocessor is designed to execute is known as the instruction set. Okay, so this instruction set carries some types of operations. Those operations are data transfer, arithmetic operations, logical operations, control flow, and input or output. You will learn about this in detail. I'll just explain the words now. Data transfer. Here the data, the input data or the output data, this data is transferred from one place to another place, right? When you are giving the input data from you, the input is sent into the computer, sent into the memory unit in the microprocessor. So this is a data transfer done there, right? So the data transfer. And arithmetic operations. Arithmetic operation means nothing but the normal calculations which you do. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These all will come under arithmetic operations. Logical operations. Logical operations means you would have known AND gate, AND or NOT, like this some operations will be there. The operations will give you the output in true or false manner. So zeros and ones will be there. It will just check, and operation will have specific like addition means you will add both, like that. In logical operations also you will have some specific operations there. So AND or NOT or XOR. So in this all operations you will have some rules. According to the rules you will get the output either as 1 or 0. 1 means true, 0 means false. Okay, so this is done in logical operations. And the next one is control flow. Control flow means it will control the operations done inside this microprocessor. And another instruction set carries out another operation like input and output operations also. Input and output means you know it already. In last first chapter itself we saw any data which is sent inside a computer means it can be done only with the input unit. And if any data has been sent to a user means it is done through output device. So this input and output also will come inside this instruction set. Okay. And the next characteristics of microprocessor is word size. The number of bits that can be processed by a processor in a single instruction is called as word size. Word size. The number of bits. How much number of bits can be processed by a processor in a single instruction, we'll say it is word size. Okay, so this word size can be determined by the amount of RAM that can be accessed by a microprocessor. Okay, the number of bits that are processed by a processor in a single instruction is called as word size. If you are giving one instruction and how many number of bits is processed in that single instruction, we'll say it is word size. Okay, to execute a single instruction, how many number of bits are used, that is word size. This can be given as the amount of RAM that can be accessed by the microprocessor. So when you are writing the word size definition, you have to write the definition of word size first. Word size means the number of bits that can be processed by the processor in a single instruction. At one instruction, how much number of bits are executed or processed by the processor is known as word size. And the next point is word size can be, this can be determined by the amount of RAM that can be accessed by the microprocessor. Right? I think you are clear with this characteristics of microprocessor chapter or this portion. Because this is a important question, so I'll just repeat it once. When you are writing this characteristics of microprocessor, first you have to write the definition of microprocessor. You have to just write two lines about microprocessor, and you can start writing the characteristics. In characteristics, microprocessor performance depends upon the following characteristics. Like that, you can write, and you can just put the heading A, clock speed; B, instruction set; C, word size. And then inside clock speed, you have to write a definition there. Every microprocessor has an internal clock that regulates the speed at which it executes the instruction. The speed at which the microprocessor executes the instruction is known as clock speed. This can be measured in megahertz or gigahertz. So you can write these 3 points inside this clock speed. And then the next one is instruction set. A command which can be given to a computer to perform any task or any operation on data is called an instruction. The basic set of machine level instructions that can a microprocessor is designed to execute is known as instruction set. Okay, this instruction set will carry out the following operations. They are data transfer, arithmetic operations, logical operations, control flow, and input or output, right? And the other characteristics of microprocessor is word size. Word size means the number of bits that can be processed by a processor in a single instruction is called as word size. And the word size can be determined by the amount of RAM that can be accessed by the microprocessor. Right. So today we have seen only the introduction about this computer organization and the basic things about microprocessor and the characteristics. So today's work is how to just read this characteristics of microprocessor. These 3 points, points are there, and the explanation of this three: clock speed, instruction set, and word size. And you have to just write it down in your note. Okay. So here, first introduction, we have seen two definitions: computer architecture and computer organization. You can write these two definitions also in your note. Computer architecture means it deals with the engineering considerations involved in designing a computer. Computer organization means it deals with the hardware components that are transparent to the programmer. Okay, so these two definitions you have to write it down in your note, and write about microprocessor and then the characteristics of microprocessor. Right, about data communication between the CPU and memory devices and all, we'll see it in the next session. This microprocessor characteristics is a very important question. Just note that question as a important question and write it down and learn that also today itself. Right? Thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care. Bye.